Hello, this is Sarah with Posh Pooch Designs, and today's video I'm going to be showing you how to crochet a fun and little and useful tissue pouch. These are great for sticking in your purse or your bag. You can add a little clip and clip it on your purse so you don't have to dig down inside to find it. They're great for sticking in your luggage as well as your gym bag or your diaper bag. And they're made to fit the basic size, this one's my granddaughter's, of your tissue pouch. Fits right inside, just like that. And you're off to go, especially in this sneezy weather. Now what you're gonna need to make this is you're gonna need some cotton yarn. And today for our demonstration, I'm going to be using this sugar and cream. It's got purples and a little bit of yellow and white in it. And I'm going to trim with this purple. I bet that's more of a lavender. You're going to need an H hook. You'll need a needle to weave in your ends and of course a pair of scissors. And of course, you'll need some tissues. And if you want to add a clip to your bag, you just need a clip that looks like this. And you can clip that on like I did this one. And this is another project that is perfect for using up your cotton scraps. And these also can be made in acrylic yarn if you want to. I just really prefer them in the cotton. So, grab your H hook and some cotton yarn and we'll make us a tissue pouch. This is a free pattern on my blog. It's just called the Cotton Tissue Pouch. And also, this is a beginner pattern. You're only using chains, single crochets, and slip stitches. And this is a great beginner pattern to practice those stitches on. Very simple, very easy. But you don't have to be a beginner to love making these. I love making them too. All right, we're going to set those aside. And we're going to go ahead and get started. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to make our slip knot. And then we're going to chain 15 chains. So I've chained my 15 chains. And we're going to begin by stitching a single crochet in the second chain from the hook. Here's our first chain. Here's our second chain. So what we're going to do is put our hook through that second chain and pull up a loop. Yarn over and go through both loops. That's our single crochet. And then we're going to place one single crochet in each chain across. And this is going to give us a total of 14 single crochets because we chained 15 in our first single crochet, or our first chain, I mean, we skipped and began stitching in the second chain from the hook. And so I'm placing one single crochet in each of the 14 chains across. And this will give us a total of 14 single crochets. All right, pulling more yarn out there, and here's my last single crochet. There's my row of single crochets. We began in the second chain from the hook and placed one single crochet in each chain. We're going to chain one. And chain one does not count as a stitch, it's merely a turning chain. And a turning chain is just a chain so that when we turn our work, it lays nicely. And we began stitching in the first single crochet of the next row. So we're going to place one single crochet in the first stitch and in each single crochet across. We're going to place one single crochet in each of the 14 single crochets across our row. There's my last single crochet, chain one, and turn. And it's a good idea to make sure that you count your stitches to make sure that you didn't add or subtract any single crochets, because we're going to be doing this for 24 rows. We're going to be making a large rectangle. So for the next 22 rows, since we already have two, we're going to do it exactly the same. Chain one, turn our work, and place one single crochet in each single crochet across our row for a total of 14 single crochets in each row. When you're first learning to crochet, it's easy to accidentally add or subtract a stitch. And that's why it's important to count your stitches and to remember that the chain one does not count as a stitch. It's merely a turning chain. And to take your time and really look at what you're doing. And don't just, okay, done, turn, done, turn. Take your time and practice. I stitched my 24 rows of single crochet, 14 stitches on a row, and I'm going to show you a trick to counting your rows. You can see a little bit of a ridge there, and this is two rows. So it's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 2, 4. So that's 24 rows. Can you see what I'm talking about? How the row has like a little line in the center, and it kind of has kind of a bump. And that's two rows. I like the way this yarn turned out too. It's kind of pretty. So there's my 24 rows, and this is our rectangle that we're going to be working with. And we're going to end up folding these in like this to make our pouch. But before we do that, we want to put a trim on it. And I'm just going to use this solid lavender for my trim. So I'm going to cut my yarn. Put my hook through the loop. Join my new color in, snug that down, and then chain one and snug that down. Now we're going to have to, whoops, my ball rolled off there. We're going to have to put single crochet stitches down the side. We'll put three single crochets in this corner, single crochet down the bottom, three single crochets in the corner, then single crochet at this side, three single crochets in the corner, and then single crochet across, and three single crochets in the corner. And when you're single crocheting down the side that's not a stitch side, it can be a little bit complicated. And so what I do, we're stitching single crochets, and so I single crochet rows, and now we're stitching single crochets as well. And so what we're going to do is place one single crochet at the end of each of the rows. And make sure you go in a stitch, not through a hole. If you single crochet through the holes, you're going to end up with gaping. Let me make my loop a little smaller there. There we go. See, I'm going to go through that first stitch on the end of that row and single crochet. Then I'm going to go through the next one. And you're going to have to work out just a little on some of them because the end of the rows can be tight. There we go. And you just want to make sure that you go in a stitch, not a hole. And there might be times where you have to go in a hole just because of the way the stitches are laying, but try not to because you don't want those big gaping holes. And you see where I'm single crocheting down the side? All right, let's that. I'm going to go right in the side of the stitch and stitch my single crochet. And when you're single crocheting evenly down the side, a lot of it is eyeball. You have to look and make sure your stitches aren't too close together or too far apart. You just have to kind of look. If you put them too close together, they'll be bunchy. And if you put them too far apart, you'll have space. So just be careful how you do it. There we go. Going through the stitches if possible. And just continue that down the side of your rectangle. And then when we get to the corner, we're going to place three single crochets in that corner. I finished single crocheting down the side, and now I'm ready to place three single crochets in my first corner. So we're going to go in that first corner and stitch three single crochets. And this just helps the corner move around smoothly. And we're at the bottom here, and so we're just going to place one single crochet in each of the chains. And this part is relatively easy because we're not having to find a spot to put our single crochets. So one single crochet in each of the chains across. So there's our first side. Here's our first corner. We put our three single crochets, and then we single crocheted one single crochet in that side where the beginning chain was, and then three single crochets in the next corner. And now we're on to our next side, and we're going to do this side exactly the same way we did this side. You're just going to put one single crochet in each of the ends of the rows, single crochet evenly going in the stitches, not the holes, if you possibly can. And we'll do it exactly the way we did that first side. Working down, set my hook down, there we go. Working down the side till we reach this corner. Then we'll place three single crochets in that corner. We'll single crochet across and three single crochets in the last corner, and then we'll join and tie off. As you can see, I've completed all four sides of single crochet with putting three single crochets in the corners. And now I'm ready to tie off. So I'm going to put my hook through and make a loop. Cut that yarn and pull that loop up just a little bit. And then I'm going to go behind them the next stitch like this and grab that loop and pull it to the back. And then I'll put the end of the yarn through it. That way you have a little less mess on the front of your work. And of course we have to weave in these ends, and we'll do that in a little bit. But what we're going to do next is fold this into the shape of our tissue pouch. So what we need to do, we've got it laid out flat. And what I do is I fold it in half, and that kind of gives me an idea of where my center is. And then like this, and then I know that I can place the sides in. and they'll be even. Now, you can take a pen or a needle if you want to secure that, if you want to, just to help you with keeping it put. And I just got a couple of big needles here I just stuck in there. If you want to do that, that way you'll help you know where your center is, because we're going to be stitching the ends up. To attach or sew our ends closed, we're going to do that with slip stitches. And so we'll take our hook and go through the first two loops on this side and the first two loops on that side. We'll put our yarn through and pull that through, and then we'll make a slip stitch. We'll come back and weave this in when we do the other two and the two that are on the inside as well. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go through the next loops on this side and the next loops on this side. Grab that yarn, pull it through, and then loop it through. That's a slip stitch because we're slipping it through. We're not making a stitch. Pull the yarn through and slip it through the next stitch, or the next loop, I should say. Going through both sides, grab the yarn and slip that loop on the other loop. Go across, grab that yarn and slip it through. All right, so now we've done the first half of the first side here. As soon as I get that loop through there, there we go, and loop that through. So now we need to do the other side, and the way we do that is we grab the first two loops on the other side and we go right in those next loops on this side and do the same thing. And that slip stitch is going to hold it in place. We'll just slip stitch on across, making sure we go through both sides because we're sewing it closed as we go. And then there's our last stitch. And this is how it should look. We started here. It's a little loose there because we have to tie that down, weave it in and tie it down, and then we have slip stitches across, forms a nice cute little braid, and then we're going to tie off here. And we'll weave those to the inside when we're done. And then we have to do the other side. And we'll do it exactly the same as this side. And then we have, like I said, a lot of tails that need to be tidied up. I went ahead and took a minute and weaved in those ends and the ones on the inside. And then I went ahead and did this one. And we stitched across with slip stitches, like on this side. And I'm going to show you how to make that little loop. And all you do is when you get to the end of your last side, you're going to chain 12. And if you want your loop smaller, you can, of course, not chain as many. That's totally up to you. And then we're going to go right back in that place where we did our last slip stitch, and pull up a loop and slip stitch, cut our yarn, and tie off. Now, we don't want that to come undone, so we do need to weave that end in. And this is the same way I did all four of the corners. I threaded that yarn on my needle, and then I went and did a loop through the last slip stitch, and then I went right inside that corner and flipped my bag over. And there's the inside of the corner. I didn't mean for my yarn to come off. There we go. And then we just make a few slip stitches going one way and then back the other because we definitely don't want this to come undone. Like that. Clip our yarn off. And here's our bag with our loop. And you can add a clip like this if you want to. Oh, this one's pretty tight. It doesn't want to let me clip it. There we go. I'll use my thumb. There we go. Now you can hook that to your diaper bag or gym bag or purse or keys for that matter. And I like to clip it on the handle. That way I'm not searching the bottom of my purse for my Kleenex. And then here's your bag, and you can just slip that right inside and put that in whatever bag that you want to. And this is our cotton tissue pouch crochet pattern.